we are going to see about managing files and directories. The Linux file system is the structure in which the information is stored. Files are organized with a hierarchy of directories. In file system hierarchy standard, directories and its structures are being described. So mainly in file system hierarchy means you're going to deal only with the directories first, and within the directories you're going to deal with the files. It explains where the files and directories should be located and what it should contain. Each directory can contain files as well as other subdirectories. Linux follows a Unix file system which is called as a hierarchical inverted tree-like structure. At the top is the root directory. Below that, it is a set of common directories in the Linux systems like bin, dev, that is device, home, lib, library, and temp, and something. Each of those directories as well as directories added to the root directory can contain subdirectories. So this is called as the Linux file system, and this diagram shows how the file system looks. This is the root directory, and below the root directory is the subdirectories like bin, boot, home, etc, usr, dev, and this particular bin directory contains the files like cat, cp, chmod, ls, and this home directory contains subdirectories called tom, michael, user 3, and the files like default start. So in this diagram, the legend rectangle shows your directory and this oval shows your file. These are called as a file and these are called as the directories. So the top is the root directory. It has been denoted by the slash symbol. The root directory slash symbols that all the Linux system have this directory structure as the root directory. And at the top is the root directory denoted by the forward slash. Everything that exists on the Linux system can be found only below this root directory. So it is at the top. First, below the root directory, many subdirectories are there. First, we are going to see about the binary directory, that is slash bin. It denotes after the root, this binary directory comes. So binaries are nothing but they are the files that contains compiled source code. It is also called as machine code. Binaries can be executed on the computer. Sometimes binaries are called as executables. It contains common Linux user commands such as ls, that is list, sort, date, and chmod. So these commands are stored as files under the bin directory. Next comes the configuration directories. It contains configured files like the parameters, initial settings for some programs. It has some subdirectories like boot, etc. So boot means it contains all the files that are needed to boot the computer, and these files don't change very often. It has the bootable Linux kernel and bootloader configuration files within this directory. So configuration directory is a subdirectory under root directory, and this configuration directory contains two subdirectories like boot and etc. So next subdirectory etc. It stores the information like machine specific configuration files, and it contains administrative configuration files also. Many times it is a name of the configuration file is the same as application, daemon, or protocol. The extension is stored as .conf, that is to denote configuration. Mainly it will all times it will have the information in the form of a plain text file that denoting whether the user has a permission that can be edited with a text editor. These configuration information will be stored on the etc file. Next comes the data directory. The data directory, as the name indicates, it is used to store the data of the system. Mainly user programs will be stored here. For example, home. Users can store their personal or project data under this home directory. It contains directories assigned to each regular user. Usually they will have some login accounts. It is common to name the particular user home directory after the username in the format. For example, after the home directory comes a user directory. In-memory directory, that is in-memory directory means it contains files of the whole system. All the device information, process running in data system related are stored in this directory. Example, device files, they appear to be like ordinary files but are not actually located on the hard disk. It is being accessed kernel is recognizing the hardware. It contains files, something related to devices like terminal devices, floppy devices, hard disk, RAM, CD-ROM, etc. Next comes the directory USR, unique system resources. Should contain shareable read-only data. Some people choose to mount user as read-only. It is mainly a trust system-oriented directory. The user will not access these files. Only they will be command to existing during the boot process. Next comes the overall structure of the Linux file system. Bin directory, it stores the commands available under the Linux system. Device file, device-related files, etc. System-related data, libraries of the data, home, it contains all the home directories of the users, USR, Unix system resources, operating system files, VARMS stores information specific to different utilities of Linux. These are the outline sketch. So, in a file system hierarchy, a file is referred by its path. Path means what? It is the file name preceded by the name of the directory containing the file. So, a path can contain a set of directories in which one directory contains another directory and so on until the root directory. The file name and different directory names in the path are separated by the slash symbol, forward slashes. What it means, it is a special character and cannot be included in a file or directory name. It is a special character, you can only use for a file name. So, what are the file naming conventions that are followed in Linux? Means the file name can be up to 256 characters long. It can contain special characters except for slash. It can contain both uppercase and lowercase alphabets. They are case sensitive. Should not have a blank or a tab. If a file name contains spaces, it can refer by typing the file name in quotes. Example, program data. Program and data has a space. So, it has been written within double quotes. Okay, next comes the path. There are two types of path. One is relative and absolute path. What is the necessity of path means? The current working directory is a directory in which the user is working. When referring to the file, instead of specifying the complete path of the file, the user can specify only the relation to the current working directory. If path and certain commands are not specified, the commands use the current directories to locate files. So, Linux takes a path name as absolute or relative. Absolute path name means the path name that starts with slash. It means full path. And relative path means the path name that starts with a character. Only the particular directory name will be denoted in the relative path. Next comes the example. To access the file September 2004 under the home Steve baseball directory. Home is a home directory. It contains one directory called Steve. It also contains a subdirectory called Baseball. And the file name is September 2004. So, in absolute path, if you want to mention, you have to mention the whole path. Slash home, slash Steve, slash Baseball and September 2004. This is called as absolute path. But in the relative path, you can just mention only the current working directory Baseball and the particular file September 2004. So, relative path is more convenient way to specify the path names because you're just only mentioning the current working directory and the file name. You're not going to use the full path. So whenever it starts with a slash character, it means it is absolute path. So referring to a home directory, Linux operating system assigns a directory to store files. Default directory is user's home directory. Also, home directory is a working directory. The path that is used to mention the home directory is with